Congratulations on purchasing a NuTone Pure Power Central Vacuum System. NuTone central vacuums are up to 5 times more powerful than upright vacuums and have a large debris capacity, so you don't have to empty them often, only 1 to 2 times per year. NuTone Pure Power's unmatched filtration ensures that dust and allergens are captured and exhausted outside of your home, helping to improve your indoor air quality. With 86% of contractors recommending NuTone products, we proudly say that NuTone is the preferred choice of electrical pros since 1936. This video will guide you through the installation process for your central vacuum system in an existing home. We will cover the basic steps to plan for and install your central vacuum system so that it works properly for years to come. Planning is the key to the successful installation of a central vacuum system. Begin by reading your installation manual and gathering the tools and installation materials recommended. Next, plan the layout of your system based on the layout and characteristics of your home. In this video, we will be installing the central vacuum system in a ranch-style home. The power unit should be located away from the general living area in an accessible position such as a garage, basement, laundry room, or any other area that is dry and remote enough that living areas will not be affected by the sound of the electric motor or exhaust noise. The unit should be mounted so that it is out of the way but still easily accessible for maintenance. If the system is to be exhausted to the outdoors, the power unit should be located on or within 15 feet of an exterior wall. Venting to areas such as decks, patios, and entranceways should be avoided. The power unit must be within 6 feet of a grounded electrical outlet providing a 120 VAC power source and must have a minimum 12-inch clearance on either side, as well as from the ceiling and an 18-inch minimum clearance above the floor. Estimate the number of inlets and feet of piping required by using the Central Vacuum Estimator tool on NuTone.com. You can also refer to the floor plan of your home to accurately determine the quantity of materials needed. Next, choose the locations for your hose inlet valves. Correctly positioned inlets will ensure trouble-free vacuuming and that the central vacuum hose is able to reach every corner of the house with enough slack to go easily around any furniture in the room. Locate inlets within 6 feet of an electrical receptacle to allow use of optional current-carrying hose unless electrified inlets are being installed. Central locations such as hallways, beside doors, and adjacent to the bottom of staircases are ideal. Areas in the middle of walls, behind doors, or where furniture may be potentially placed should be avoided. A 30-foot string, the length of a typical central vacuum hose, can help you to easily determine whether you will be able to reach all areas to be vacuumed with that inlet placement. Finally, plan the path of your piping network. The main trunk line connects the furthest inlet valve to the power unit. In the ranch home installation shown in this video, the trunk line runs horizontally along the length of the house through the attic. Consult your installation manual for recommended pipe layouts for other house types. Branch lines run vertically through walls and connect the trunk line to the inlet locations. As with the trunk line, branch lines should be kept as straight as possible. Always connect your branch line to the trunk line from a horizontal position or above the trunk line to avoid the accumulation of debris and heavier objects, pennies, paper clips, etc., from falling into the branch line due to gravity. Tight 90-degree fittings are only to be used on connections to hose inlets or automatic dustpan inlets. Full-sized sweep 90, 45, or 30-degree fittings should be used throughout the rest of the piping system to minimize the risk of clogs. You can use the existing features of your home, such as attics, closets, or laundry chutes, to run your piping network to minimize damage to your walls. Ensure that the path you choose does not interfere with any plumbing or electrical systems before you start to install your inlets. To avoid condensation in the tubing when installing in the attic, cover the tubing with insulation. Once you have completed your plan, start your installation by mounting the inlets. From the basement or attic, locate the wall plate belonging to the interior wall where your inlet will be placed and measure to find the center of the plate. Drill a 2.5 diameter access hole in the center of the plate and check for obstructions in the wall using a flashlight. Gather the materials needed to assemble a length of piping. This length of piping will be your first branch line. Before cutting each piece of piping, measure the length you need. allow 5/8 inch of piping for inserting into fittings and 1 1/2 inches for placing into flexible piping. Cut plastic piping with a hacksaw or pipe cutter, ensuring your cut is square. For flexible piping, use wire cutters or tin snips instead of a saw. After the piping is cut to length, use steel wool to remove any burrs from the inside of cut piping and a file to bevel the outside edges so it will easily slide into the fitting. To ensure a good seal, use steel wool or light grain sandpaper to buff the surface of the pipe that will be glued. To make a joint, dry fit the pipe into the fitting, aligning the two parts as they will be installed. Mark the pipe and fitting so you can quickly realign the joint. To glue, apply an inch wide band of cement only to the outside of the pipe. Insert the pipe into the fitting with the alignment marks a quarter turn apart, then quickly push and turn the fitting to align the marks and spread the cement. Allow 1 minute for the joint to dry. On the end of the piping for your first branch line, glue a short 90 degree fitting that will be used to attach to the inlet. Next, run a length of low voltage wiring along the piping, leaving at least an additional 6 inches at the end in order to connect to the inlet faceplate. As you go, secure the wire with electrical tape at regular intervals. Take the branch line you have just assembled and insert it into the access hole and through the wall cavity until it reaches the location of your planned inlet. Ensure that enough pipe is protruding from the top of the access hole so that you can later connect this branch line to the trunk line in your attic. Now you are ready to make your inlet cutouts. Using careful measurements, mark the spot on the face of the wall where your inlet will be placed. This should be 18 inches up from the floor level and directly in line with where the branch line you just installed is now sitting behind the wall. Using the mounting bracket provided with your inlet as a guide, trace a rectangle on the wall centered over this mark. Drill a pilot hole on your center mark and cut the inlet tracing out of the drywall. Reach through the inlet hole and pull the 90 degree elbow on your branch line up to the inlet cutout so that it is easier to work with. Cut or snap off the nail plate from your inlet bracket and apply the PVC cement along the outside of the connection of the bracket. Then attach the 90 degree elbow to the inlet bracket. Feed the low voltage wire through the guide on the bracket. Now you are ready to mount the bracket and install the inlet. Attach the wiring to the inlet, place the inlet bracket inside the wall, and sandwich the wall between the inlet's bracket and faceplate, securing it in place with screws. For specific details on installing the style of inlet you have purchased for your home, refer to your installation guide. An automatic dustpan or toe kick inlet is a very popular add-on. These inlets are typically installed under a cabinet in the kitchen, bathroom, or laundry room and allow you to sweep debris directly into your central vacuum system for fast and easy spot cleaning. Detailed instructions for installing automatic dustpan inlets can be found in your power unit's installation manual. Once you've completed the branch lines, start the trunk line at the farthest branch line from the power unit. Add a sweep fitting to the end of your branch line. Starting at the sweep you've just attached, join lengths of straight PVC piping using stop couplings until you reach the next branch line. Connect the branch lines and trunk line together by fitting one end of a small piece of piping to the sweep fitting and the other end to a T that also attaches to your trunk line. The type of T you use will depend on the configuration of your install. Always make sure the T connects with the airflow going toward the power unit. If you encounter unavoidable obstacles, such as a chimney, construct the piping around the obstacle. You can also use a piece of flexible piping to circumvent an obstacle. As you build your trunk line, run low voltage wiring along the trunk, securing the wire with electrical tape at regular intervals to prevent sagging. At the junction of every branch line and the trunk line, cut the trunk line wire and connect it to the branch line wire. Connect this wiring in groups of threes with one branch wire, one incoming trunk line wire, and one outgoing trunk line wire. Insulate all wire connections with electrical tape. Continue with the trunk line until you reach the location where you have planned the access hole for your power unit's intake. Drill the access hole in a 2 1/2 inch diameter. Connect an elbow to the trunk line so that it aligns over the intake access hole. You will make the intake pipe connection after you have installed the power unit. The final step is to mount your power unit and connect it to the piping network. Be sure to screw the wall mounting bracket directly to a wall stud for a solid installation. Position the wall mounting bracket to the location you have planned and use the provided screws to secure the mounting bracket to the wall through the upper and lower mounting holes. Hang the power unit onto the wall mounting bracket. Ensure the back brackets of the power unit are engaged with corresponding wall bracket fingers. Pull the power unit down to secure. The air intake line connects to the right side of the power unit. This configuration can easily be changed to the left side of the unit by removing the screws and flipping the intake 180 degrees before reassembling. On bag equip models, rotate the bag adapter inside the canister 180 degrees and align the triangle on the intake elbow with the small inclined stud on the bag adapter. Run pipe from the intake access hole to the air intake on the power unit. Insert the end of the pipe into the power unit's air intake and secure by hand tightening the screw and nut provided. Do not glue this connection. Connect the low voltage wiring to the power unit's low voltage tabs using the included crimp connectors and low voltage harness. If your central vacuum will be vented to the outside, you will require an exhaust line. Exhaust lines work best when limited to 15 feet long or less with minimal bends. Simply open an inlet cover and insert your hose to turn on the system to enjoy quiet, powerful cleaning with your NuTone Pure Power Central Vacuum. Thank you for watching.